Severe storms have pummeled the southeast. Strong winds, golf ball-sized hail and lightning strikes, leaving a trail of destruction. One man injured in the chaos and rushed to hospital. Let's go live to Alex Heinke at the PA. Alex, what happened?
A large tree, Jonathan. Early indications suggesting a large gum tree has fallen on top of a man, pinning him to the ground in a Carolee backyard. We understand this man in his 30s has suffered head, neck and shoulder injuries, as you mentioned, in the PA hospital in a serious but stable condition. And Jonathan, it wasn't only humans on the firing lines this afternoon as this supercell smashed the southeast. Walking out to watch the storms roll in, then this. Watch again, the lightning strike splintering the tree in this Oxley backyard.
Oh my God, Katie!
It smelled like gunpowder, and our ears were ringing, so it was pretty intense.
You can imagine Bianca's surprise. Until today, she'd never even seen hail before.
Like the night and day, really, in experiences.
Well, from trees being damaged to doing the damage, this one came crashing down on a Runcorn home. You can see it's completely leveled the awning, but done extensive damage to the ceiling, hitting the corner of the home. There was a family inside at the time, but thankfully, they're uninjured. For the second day running, the southeast copped it. We were promised rain this week, and today we got that and a whole lot more. The hail, relentless. Wave after wave, the second cell did most of the damage, battering the western suburbs, welcomed by some, but not others. The Warrego Highway at a standstill, cut by a fallen tree.
That's the Warrego Highway.
30,000 lightning strikes, 70 kilometre an hour winds, tens of millimetres of rain, leaving 30,000 without power in the southeast. And the Bureau says it's not over yet.
Possible showers and storms tomorrow, but everything ramping up again on Tuesday when we see the next upper trough come through.
And it's still only spring. Alex Heinke, Nine News.
Live to weather expert Gary Youngbury. Now, Gaz, just how much rain did we see?
Oh, Jono, firstly, I'm at King George Square. It's dry at the moment. Less than 2 hours ago, it's absolutely flogging down. We've had widespread falls of 20 to 30 millimetres, particularly around Brisbane, East Brisbane, and also places like Rochedale, Forest Lake, the sort of southern and southwestern suburbs as that line of severe storms cross the southeast. Let's have a look at the radar, wind back the clock just a few hours, and you'll see that main line of storms has now moved offshore, which is good news. There's still a severe thunderstorm warning in place. In fact, there is a storm cell west of Harrisville that's tracking towards Boona within the next hour, and also a smaller cluster of storms heading towards Coolangatta and also the Tweed district in the next 30 minutes or so. So still a few storms lingering. The main line of storms has moved offshore, which is very good news. But we've got a week, or still a few days of storms into next week, potentially severe, more to come. All those details, 7-day outlook, not far away, Jono.
Gary, thank you.